the leader.
Hello, Mr. Ollivander. I wondered if you might be able to help me with something.
Yes. Professor Fig sent an owl informing me that you'd be coming. He was a bit cryptic, said you need to have a special wand crafted, that you'd bring me the materials.
Yes, sir. I have them here.
Oh, my. How extraordinary. Remarkable design. I will be honest, I have never crafted a wand in this fashion. Repaired broken wands, of course, but this is something else entirely. Keeping me on my toes, aren't you? I think I can work with what you've brought me. Let me see what I can do. It is done. I should warn you, I've never seen a wand like this before. My suspicion, as Professor Fig implied in his letter, is that it serves a unique purpose. I doubt you shall find much use for it otherwise.
I understand. Thank you, sir.
I'm afraid you're on your own. I've ensured that we have a moment to ourselves. Oh, come, come. No need for such theatrics. In light of what Ranrok now knows, you must agree that our interests are aligned.
Our interests will never be aligned.
You would let goblins take what is rightfully ours? The final repository belongs to wizard kind. We would be fools not to work together. What's that you've got there? Might this sudden visit to the Wand Maker have something to do with our mutual pursuit?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
That repository is my birthright!
Charles Rookwood wouldn't have wanted you near it.
The arrogance. Should have known better than to try and reason with a child. I've always said, children should be seen and not heard.
Expelliarmus!
Disarm my wand and feel my wrath!
look up.
It's Monster!
You will not survive this. You die.
I'm just warming up.
Rebellion. I can't believe it. Rookwood's reign is finally over. I'll need to send an owl to Natty right away. For now, though, I need to get back to the map chamber and tell Fig what happened. Victor Rookwood is dead. He confronted me as I left Ollivander's with the Keeper's wand. I had to defend myself.
Godric's heart, are you all right? I know you're well able to defend yourself. I've seen it often enough. But Rookwood himself...
He destroyed so many lives and he wouldn't have stopped. I'm glad I was able to put an end to him.
You're right. He wouldn't have stopped. You did what you had to do. The wizarding community owes you a great debt.
Thank you for saying so, Professor. I'm ready for what's next.
All right, then. The Keepers have been waiting.
You have completed all of our trials, and you have done so under circumstances even I did not foresee. You understand now why all of this was necessary. The portkey, the vault, the locket, the book, the trials, to ensure that one with the ability you and I share would make the same choice that San, Neve, Charles, and I did.
Now that you have witnessed my memory, you understand all that is at stake. Not everyone is what they seem.
As you know, light does not exist without shadow, nor shadow without light. Simply because you can eliminate darkness does not always mean that you should.
Even the most well-meaning and competent amongst us cannot possibly know the consequences of manipulating what should be beyond our reach.
What lies in the repository must never be released. Resist the temptation to destroy or control it. The magic that you have so carefully honed must now be used only to protect the secret we keep. You have the wand. You will know when to wield it. We leave our legacy in your hands.
Astonishing. That must be the way to the repository.
We can only hope that we're not too late, and that we find nothing but a repository undisturbed beyond this door.
I should hope that the enchantments protecting the castle would protect against an incursion from below.
I fear they may not. Although, if they don't now, I can assure you they will in the future.
Were you able to reach Professor Weasley?
I was. Hopefully she and the others will arrive soon. They know where to find the door through which we entered.
Thank you.
Professor, that wall, that's the way forward.
Very perceptive, my young friend. It worked. Let's go.
Ranrock must be getting closer to finding the repository.
I think.
Why?
We're getting closer, Professor. That way.
Somehow evaded the castle's defensive charms.
Steer them this way! We shall make quick work of them!
Oh. They got this!
Now nice.
Now fly.
Defender! You won't get away with it.
Trigger!
I'm relieved we got here before Ranrok.
I can't believe this is it. The repository has been under the castle for hundreds of years.
Think of all the pain that created it. This is what Miriam, George, your friend Lodgok, and countless others died for. Miriam believed this forgotten magic could be used for such good. But she did not know the risks. She did not see what the Keepers have shown you. What Isadora showed you. You are now the Keeper of whatever power it holds. What do you intend to do with it?
I plan to leave the repository as it is.
I'm pleased to hear that. I've been thinking.
What is it, Professor?
I spent all year trying to keep our journey a secret from everyone, including Professor Weasley. But now I wonder if I should have shared it with her, and the others, sooner. Trusted them more.
The Keepers wanted this secret to be locked away forever. How long will you keep it?
I plan to keep it secret for now. But in time, when I am ready, I plan to tell those I trust everything and accept their help.
I believe that is what Miriam would have wanted. We should trust in others. If anyone can rise to this challenge, my friend, it is you.
The arrogance of wizard kind. Goblins built this repository. It belongs to us.
Enough, Ranrok. It was never yours.
I've been wanting to play with this.
Miriam's wand.
If she'd simply handed over the container, all of this could have been avoided. Foolish, self-important witch. Seems you were two of a kind. She didn't know when to give up either.
Super.
Thank you. Miriam. Miriam would have loved you, my young friend. The wizarding world could not be in more capable hands.
Professor Eleazar Fig. I dare say he was a beloved professor to many of you, certainly a long-standing colleague to his peers. A famed adventurer and seeker of knowledge, he built a reputation charging into the unknown, brazenly disregarding both discretion and safety, providing perhaps a rather unfortunate lesson for us all. His devotion to adventure was rivaled only by his dedication to Hogwarts. And of course, to his wife, Midi, whom we lost much too soon as well.
Professor Fig represented the best of all of us. Oh, he could be deviously clever, possessed a brilliantly inquisitive mind, and was the most loyal of friends. But perhaps it was his remarkable courage, for which we will all be forever indebted to him. If not for Professor Fig, well, I can say with confidence that if not for him, many of us, let alone Hogwarts, would not be here today. Those that knew him best will agree that we must now honor him as only Hogwarts can, by wisely, resourcefully, justly and bravely facing all that lies ahead.
To Professor Fig!
Meet me as soon as...
Can't believe we lost Fig. I didn't know him as well as you did, but I know he was a good man. Glad Weasley spoke for him. She honored him well. Fig will be well remembered. I wish the same could have been done for my uncle. I wonder if there's a chance Anne would meet me.
Sebastian, I can't imagine what you and Anne are going through. Perhaps you'll hear from her soon.
I hope so. I'll let you know.
Sebastian, there's something you should know. It's to do with Victor Rookwood.
I heard a rumor that he confronted you outside of Ollivander's. Sounds as if he faced quite a fight.
The rumors are true, and I did, but it's not that. Just before Rookwood attacked, he uttered something familiar. The same words Anne heard before she was cursed. Children should be seen and not heard.
Wait, what are you saying?
It wasn't one of Ranrock's loyalists who cursed Anne. It was Rookwood. It was Rookwood all along.
This can't be. It was the loyalists. It's always been them. The night Anne was cursed, all she saw were goblins.
Once Rookwood allied with Ranrock, Isidore's estate became of interest to them both. That's why Rookwood was there the night Anne was cursed. He was working with Ranrok. When he saw your sister, well, he didn't want anyone to know.
So he cursed her, and she's never been the same. So cruel. Rookwood deserved what he got. Thank you for telling me. It wasn't a goblin. I suppose I owe you an apology. All this time I thought goblins were the enemy. But it was never that simple. Ominous said he's spoken with Anne. I wonder if she'll see me. I'll find out and send word when I know more. Glad you came.
Sebastian, I've received your owl. What's happened?
Ominous spoke with Anne about what happened with my Uncle Solomon. She believes I should pay for what I did, but she won't turn me in. She said the guilt I'll have to live with is punishment enough.
I'm so sorry, but I'm glad you know that you can at least try to move on now.
The thing is, I think I've lost my sister, my twin, forever. She refuses to even see me. I can't blame her. I couldn't really blame any of you if you gave up on me entirely. You all believed in me, and I let you all down.
Anne may just need some time. Surely one day she'll be able to forgive you.
I hope you're right. I realize I can't undo what's been done, but I can try every day to make up for it. I owe you and Ominous everything for standing by me.
Well, it wasn't easy. But I believe in you, Sebastian. I've had a sense about you since that first day in Defense Against the Dark Arts.
Seems so long ago. Thank you. I have no idea what's to come, but I'm grateful for your friendship. I'm glad you came to Hogwarts.
Are you ready to finish Harlow?
I'm ready to finish Harlow once and for all. What is your plan?
I received an owl from Mrs. Bickle. She wondered if we were having any luck going after Harlow. Suggested we could gather evidence from a friend near Manor Cape.
But she warned us to stay out of it. Was rather adamant about it.
Precisely.
Harlow knows that we saved Archie, and that we rescued Mr. Rabe. The letter didn't come from Mrs. Bickle, did it?
I do not believe it did. Harlow intends to ambush us.
But now we have the upper hand. We can prepare.
We are stronger than Harlow, and he knows it. That's why he's resorting to this sort of trickery. We must go.
I don't know if we should be rushing into this.
If he thinks we are aware of his plans, he may call off the ambush. We should behave as he expects us to.
Fair point. All right, let's go.
Brilliant. Harlow's reign ends today.
Perhaps we ought to inform Officer Singer of our plans.
I already sent her an owl to let her know that we were following a lead given to us by Mrs. Bickle.
Are you concerned she might tell your mother?
Indeed she will, but so be it. I am tired of hiding it from her. My mother needs to understand that I will not be safe from the Ashwinders until everyone is. I shall pursue them until they are finished. And I think she knows that. As do you.
Where is he?
I do not know. We should look around.
I'll make you kill.
Siona, innit? And her excruciatingly loyal companion. You two have done quite a bit of damage to my business interests. But I must grudgingly give you some credit. What was once a mere annoyance has become remarkably problematic. Fortunately, I pride myself on my problem-solving skills.
You're not even strong! Avon, you don't! What happened to be your downfall, Hallo? Mark my words!
Are you sure you are up for a visitor?
Yes, Mother. I feel fine, and it will do me good to see my friend.
Very well. But do not overdo it, Natsai.
I know, Mother. It is good to see you, my friend.
I'm glad to see you're doing so well.
I am doing better than it appears. I am only here because my mother insisted. just to be safe. I was relieved when she told me that you were all right.
Only because of you. How are you feeling?
Well, I've had better days, but Nurse Blaney says that I am on the mend.
I'm sorry, Natty. It's my fault you got hurt.
What? No. Do not blame yourself for this. The moment that I saw Harlow aim his wand at you, well...
You did what came naturally.
I suppose it was instinct. Yes. I could not simply stand there and let you get hurt.
Then I shouldn't feel guilty.
Of course not. There was nothing that you... Oh. Oh my. I cannot believe that it took me this long to see it. He made a choice. Based on instinct, my father, you, my friend, are no more to blame for my injuries today than I am to blame for my father's sacrifice years ago.
From what I know of him, it seems there's a lot of your father in you.
That's very kind of you to say. I hope that you are right. This has all been a bit much, hasn't it? A battle here at Hogwarts, everything we have done to take down Harlow and the rest of Rookwood's lot. But we have done it. Rookwood is dead, Harlow is on his way to Azkaban, and the rest of them are on the run. A few of the dregs will still be about, fighting for their lost cause. But Rookwood's enterprise has fallen apart.
Everything is safer now because of us, because of you.
Thank you, but we make a formidable team. You, my fellow traveler, have enriched my time at Hogwarts beyond anything I could have imagined. Thank you. I believe your friendship to be one of the most important in my life. Thank you for coming to visit me. It is always good to see you.
Dear, do you mind the tiles?
If someone gets struck by a cursed broom, we do hope it's you.
Professor Weasley, you wanted to see me?
I did. We haven't had a chance to speak since... I know you were quite close with Professor Fig.
Hogwarts won't be the same without him.
No, it won't. But I can assure you that he would want us to press on, and that he would rest easy knowing that the future of the wizarding world is in hands like yours.
Thank you, Professor.
You've had quite a year, both inside and outside of Hogwarts. I've heard all sorts of rumors. You've ridden a graphorn, befriended a goblin, rescued hippogriffs, even somehow ingratiated yourself with the Headless Hunt.
How did you...
It's harder to keep secrets around here than one might suspect. I'm just glad you found such a good friend in Miss Sweeting. It's nice to see her engaging more with her classmates. There have evidently been Snidget sightings in the area lately. If the centaurs are to be believed, two Hogwarts students are behind it.
I'm certain I don't know what...
No need to discuss it further. What I would like to discuss is your wizard's field guide. May I see it?
Of course. What do you think, Professor?
I think you've been busy this year. I see some progress here, but quite a bit of your field guide has yet to be completed. Fortunately, you do have some time to prepare for your OWLs. I will confess, I had a sense about you from that first moment you came bursting in, late, to the sorting ceremony. I am pleased to see that my instincts were correct. To think you've only been with us a year and you'll already be taking your OWLs, well, it's nothing short of astonishing.
Thank you, Professor. for everything.
You are most welcome. I look forward to seeing what you do during the rest of your time with us.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most pleased to be included.
This year, we have seen our students exemplify the bravery of Godric Gryffindor. And now we can finish. The loyalty of Helga Hufflepuff. The wisdom of Rowena Ravenclaw. And the ambition of Salazar Slytherin. And so, the winner of this year's House Cup...
Excuse me, Headmaster, if I may. One particular student's heroism during the attack on Hogwarts, not to mention the level to which they have excelled in their coursework, as a new student, no less. Well, it would seem that it certainly merits... I'd say 100 points to their house. Wouldn't you agree?
Ah, yes. Thank you, Professor Weasley. I suppose we have our...